What is up, everyone? It's the Drummer Nerd, and welcome back to another ARK Survival Evolved Let's Play on the Sandbox Survivor server. I wanted to take a second to thank everyone for all their support so far. We had kind of a bit of a spike in views this week, and I really, really appreciate all the views and the likes and the comments and the subs and everything you guys have been doing so far. So, just a quick little shout out to everybody. You're awesome. Thanks again. Today, we're going to spend a little bit of time working on kind of a barn, I guess, is the best way to describe it. It's really not going to be shaped like a barn. It's going to be kind of organic in how it's going to shape. I'm not really sure exactly how I'm going to do this yet. I've been thinking about it for a while. But we're going to build a barn-type building kind of over in this area over here. And it's going to house all the dinos that we're going to be using specifically for egg farming purposes. And we'll probably even build a little room in the middle of it to be used for the eggs that we get from breeding. Basically incubating the dinos, getting them fed, getting them ready to go. And I wanted to show you one of the things that we've got here so far, because obviously, you know, if we're gathering eggs, we're doing it mostly for the kibble. And check out all of the stuff that I've been getting. Tons of advanced crops. This stuff's just been going for days. I haven't really been making much kibble other than helping RC make some of the Quetzal Egg kibble for the Giga Gojira. And we've got a little bit of prime meat jerky going on upstairs. How many of these? I got like four or five of them going right now. So pretty soon here, we're going to be really stocked up and ready to go for making more and more kibble, so we can start going after some more of those high-level teams and do some more breeding stuff. So I figured today we'll get started with at least outlining, maybe getting the first little pieces of a building going over here. Again, I've only really got a little bit of an idea of how I want this to go. And one of the problems with building over in this area is, even though it seems like it's fairly flat, there is a little bit of a slope to this whole section here. So if we want to build anything and have it be level, we're really going to need to use the ceilings and the wooden posts here, pillars, as foundations rather than actual foundations. So I kind of want to play around a little bit here with how that's going to lay out. I think we're going to have to kind of come up to a point here where we just kind of set down somewhere. Maybe, come here. Close enough. I should be able to go back fairly far over here. You know what? Let's try it. Let's get... I don't want to go all the way up yet, though. I don't want to go all the way up yet, though. Don't make me go all the way up yet. Is that making me go all the way up? It is. I want to use the same trick that we did with the other building there, which was to... Well, you know how we started that, though, was we placed the foundation down first. Do I have enough stuff to make a foundation out of thatch? Can I just use one of the ones that's nearby here? It's just a little bit too low. That one's a little bit too low, too. What do we need? Alright, so this is probably the better idea anyway. Let's get about as far up as I can. And place foundation. Sweet. Okay. So now I should be able to take the roof, place the roof, and now place a pillar there. Yes. Cool. So this way we can lay out what essentially is going to be the floor. But when we're ready, I can replace right above the top there so we don't have the little pieces of the post sticking out the top, which get really annoying. I don't like the way that it looks. And I really, really want to try to make this be as smooth and even as possible, because... Well, nothing looks worse than having a really cool build that just has a couple of janky spots because you couldn't get everything to be nice and level. So I have a feeling that this is going to have to go fairly far out here. You can basically expect one space wide for each dino. You can get some of the smaller ones to fit in the smaller space than that, but if we just plan for the larger dinos and make as much space as we need here... So this is going to be a fairly sizable structure, but the nice part about building it this large is that I can kind of play around with the size as much as I want, And again, building it out of cheap materials like the wood pillars and the thatch roofs makes it even easier, because who cares if I gotta break this stuff to put more stuff down? It doesn't really matter. It's not a big deal. Oh. Oh, there's a fight. That didn't last long. Good job. Good job, lightsaber. I knew there was a reason I let you fight stuff. Okay, so the next step here is going to be actually to place down some walls and get some ramps going. More items that I don't have on me. I might need to go make some more. Are you going to be encumbered if I jump on you? We're going to be able to run? No, we can't run. Okay. We'll be back with more materials. Alright, back again. I'm going to start on this side here, because I feel like this is going to be probably the far end of the building. And if I expand, I'll go down this way. And more than likely, we'll expand up a little bit for some of the smaller dinos. But this is what we're going to do here. And you may have seen this build in any one of at least two other videos that I've got where I've explained the concept that I like to use behind this build. But it is to... is this in the right spot? Yeah, okay. It's to use ramps for the dinos so that you can walk the dinos up the ramps and they'll kind of hang out over the ledge a little bit, and when they drop eggs, the eggs will roll down. Now that I'm thinking about it though, I might need to move this up forward one, because with things like the trikes, which we have used in the past, the problem that you'll run into is you need a little bit of a ledge over the top of this for the trikes to hang out on, or they won't actually sit over the edge. It'll be kind of a weird angle. And the other problem with that too is that if we get too close, I won't be able to finish the back of the building. So why don't we... I don't want to go there. I want to start maybe here. That's fine. And that's why we made this building as long as we did, so we could play around with stuff like this. See, it works out. It was smarter than I thought it was. So we can place this here. And we can kind of do the same thing at least a little ways down. And I'm not looking to build all of this stuff here right now. What I want to do is kind of prototype this out. And then I'll spend a little bit of time, likely off camera, actually building some of the stuff that we're doing here. So you can at least get a good idea of what I'm thinking of doing. And then ultimately you'll see what I've done when it's completed. Alrighty, little update. I'm a little heavy. I got a bunch of stuff on me. So I ended up probably getting a little bit ahead of myself and maybe doing a little bit too much out here, but we placed down these stone ceilings on top so that you can no longer see the wood pillars sticking through the bottom of the ceiling. What's cool is I actually am leaving the thatch for now. We'll eventually rip that all out, but the thatch is allowing me to basically expand however I want to without running into the issue of possibly having the bottom of the pillar sticking out of our ceiling. And we put the walls where we expected to, and it's working good. I did forget that the scorpions take up a little bit more width than just one foundation or ramp. So if I want to stick these guys in like this, ultimately they'll probably go into a different room. But if I want to stick them like this and have the male alongside them, I'm going to have to go out one more here to make sure that they all fit. It's no problem, but I'm not going to do it now because I will have to add another foundation in order for this to work on this side. And I don't feel like doing that right now because these guys all fit up here fine for the moment. There's no real issue with where they are other than I need to add a feeding trough over here pretty soon. I usually will stick that back behind here because there's a bit of real estate. Even if I get underneath there is one way I've done it, which I think it's nice because it hides it. It's easy to get to, and it's not like it's difficult to get spoiled meat on a server like this. I'll put a bunch of raw meat in there tonight, and by tomorrow it'll all be spoiled and ready for these guys to eat. But since we don't really have any other dinos that are producing eggs right now, I don't have any reason to expand beyond this point. So pretty soon here we'll throw up some walls and we'll make it look a little bit pretty, but I want to make sure that we have a little bit of a space for incubating eggs, because that's going to be one of the things that we're going to be working on here very soon. So I'm going to use this space here, this 3x6, I think this is, space. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to enclose this. And we're going to place down I believe we're going to place down a number of air conditioners. I'm not sure exactly how many I'll be able to fit. Hopefully I'll be able to fit 5 or 6 of them along the back wall here. We'll probably throw the generator underneath because I'll want to wire up the bottom of this place so that we can get lights everywhere. I did bring the materials that I need, I believe, for us to wall this off. I am going to put the window frame there. Hopefully we'll just be able to throw a cover on. Okay, are you going to be the right direction? Sweet. Okay, cool. Let's put that mural. And are you the right direction? Yes, you are. Awesome. We're moving along so far. Let's see if this will do the same thing on this side. Are you doing the right direction? Yes. Sweet. Okay. Yeah? All right. We don't need the other window frame. We're not going to use that quite yet. Let's get some walls going on the outside here. Now, I have been facing the walls a very specific way so that when you're actually inside, you're looking at the inside of the walls. So, hopefully this will place... Awesome. That's exactly how we want. It's a little harder when you're not doing it on the edge like that. It wants to place the other way. So it can get to be a little bit interesting. If you didn't know this, when you're placing a wall, if you hit the E button, it'll change its orientation. And it'll look like that instead if you change the orientation. So we'll dump that because that's not what I wanted. And place this in the right spot. Is that the right spot? Cool. Awesome. And then we're moving along now. This is pretty sweet. And we should now be able to snap this. Whoa. Okay. Are you the right way? Yes, we are. Stop hitting that button. Sweet. Once we finish this up, we'll see if we have enough materials to actually build the fridge. Hopefully I've got enough materials and we don't have to make a material run. I know that I'll have enough metal. I mean, I'll have metal for days. It's all the other stuff I'm not sure if I have enough of. Make sure those are all facing the right way because I'm sure that if I place this... Yeah, look at that. That wants to snap the wrong way. Go the wrong way, buddy. Don't do that to me. There we go. Nice and OCD friendly. So we'll get a little cover here. Oh, you know, we are going to have to put... I need another wall. I need a door frame so we can get a door on here as well. So we should be able to craft those up pretty quick, hopefully. And we should be able to craft up the fridges. We're using air conditioners. Fridges would be bad. That's not going to get us anywhere. So let's go see if we can get the air conditioners made up. See if I've got enough materials for it. I want to check first. Hopefully we don't have to go out. So we'll need that. We'll need the generator. We'll probably want some lights. And we'll probably need some cable and an outlet. Let's see. Structures. Electric? Air conditioner. So we have enough... Well, metal's not on here. I gotta go grab some metal, but... We'll have enough metal. That's easy enough. We need some electronics, and we need some polymer. We have enough obsidian for the polymer, so let's see if we can get... Ooh, wait. This is gonna take a lot. Come on! Go inside! So if I'm gonna make 5, that's a lot of math. And we're going to get some of the other components crafted up before we're ready to make these. So I'll get those components crafted up, and when we're ready to make the refrigerator, we'll come right back. Stop. Not refrigerator. Dude, look at the right one. When I'm ready to make these guys, air conditioners, we'll be right back. All right, everything should just about be made up here. Let's, you know. Well, that's that's not a spot for a window. We've been needing to put these on here for a while. It's about time. Spent all that time building this cool looking house. I haven't really put much effort into it after that. Gotta get this place wired up for lights and stuff too. Modern age. Okay, let's get... Yeah, okay. Doo-doo-doo. Putting these windows on. They're pretty sweet looking windows. Alright, so let's go over to our fabricator here. And let's turn on this noisy monster. And let's see, we need to make structures. Electrical. I need a generator. I'll need an outlet. We'll definitely need a vertical cable. Two vertical cables. Let's just grab that. Let's grab this guy, and this guy, and this guy. Now, we need electrical. I think I can make, I should be able to make five of these if I had put all the crystal in here that I needed. We should be well stocked up on crystals, so it should be okay. Electric. Yes, sweet, so we can build four. And I was doing something kind of cool over here. Let's do this some more if I got all the materials that I need. I'm going to do one. One, two, three, one, one. So what we're going to do is I'm going to stick... Gosh, that thing is noisy. Oh my goodness. We're going to stick the generator in a cool metal room downstairs because you know what? I can. And it's sweet. Alright, so we got air conditioner, and now I think I wanted some structures, electric. You know what, let's just make four of these. I don't know whether or not I'll need to be able, I'll be able to place all of them, but you know what, they're cool. We've only really played around with them in one spot here, so I want to make sure that we can play around with that a little bit more. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Cool, turn that noisy thing off. Is it getting dark again already? Yeah, it's still okay outside. I may not have made adjustments to the gamma to put it back where it's supposed to be. What is going on over here? Is that dude just glitching or is he, she under attack? You know what, lightsaber? Why don't you come over here? Why don't you come chill on this side, because I've seen some stuff run around here. You're going to be guard tiger. Sure. We'll go with that. Guard tiger. Alright, so what do we need to do here? First and foremost, let's put this guy on the back here before I forget. Sweet. Okay, let's get Mr. Doorframe on here as well. Even better. Awesome, that's done. Let's get this door on and make sure I can still fit through it with this ramp here. Cool, I'm not too tall for my own buildings. That's awesome. Let's see. You know what would be really cool is if we put... The thing is, you really don't need really more than like one of these things in a room to really light it up, but we're going to be extra cool and we're going to put one in this corner. And we're going to put one in this corner. And we'll never have to worry about light in this room. Ever. Let's grab our air conditioners. I'm going to kind of center one of these maybe here-ish. Yeah, you know what? Right around where our foundation is. And let's see how close I can get these things. All right, like right on top of one another. And hopefully it doesn't matter which direction it's pointed. Because it all looks like they're pointed the wrong direction. I have no idea how that works. I really hope I don't have to fix that because that's... That's going to be costly. Luckily, this area in particular is not difficult to climate control. Because it's just always nice. It's always nice. Alright, so we're right about here. Let's try this. Let's see if this does what... Whoa, 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 whoa! Okay. I guess you're gonna snap right there. I mean, I'm okay with it if you're okay with it. Let's go here, and meow, and meow. And let's get the generator inside. Make sure the generator fits where we want it to fit. These things are huge. Should be good there, right? Right? Are you going to be sticking out the back? Nope. Cool. It fits. Mostly. Let's get our vertical cable going. And hopefully I can just stick an electrical outlet on the top of it. You're going to go right into the building, aren't you? I might be okay with that. Let's see. Let's see what happens. Yes. There's a cable sticking out of the ground. And it's getting an electrical outlet. Look at that. That's going to power the whole thing. Okay, let's go get some gas. I got to try this. Let's get some gas. Okay, here's a curiosity. This is not... this building's not going to be tall enough for this. I got to get a couple more. We really probably don't need a ceiling for that. Of course, the object is obstructed. All right. Fine. I want it to look cool. We'll just make a couple more items. I'm sure I've got enough metal for all that stuff. While we're at it, we'll grab some oil. Let's see. One more foundation. Three more walls there. Six more walls. I don't know. We'll make like seven walls. Let's see. You don't need that there. What are you doing there? Structures, metal. One more foundation. What am I missing? Really? Out of metal there, huh? That's okay, I got plenty more of it. Okay, structures, metal. We're gonna need one more ceiling. I'm gonna need one, two, three, just to make all the walls. That might, it's either going to just be enough, or it won't be enough. It's definitely not going to be more than enough. Let's hope that it's just enough so I don't have to come back in here and make more stuff. But I think we got everything we need, so this should be good. Let's get back out, Mira. Close the door. Oh, no, wait. We're doing this all wrong. Come here, Spike. We've been doing this all wrong the whole time. We cannot be doing building without Spike. I can't believe that we forgot him in there the whole time. I'm so sorry, Spike. These parasers are so annoying. You're just standing in the wrong spot there. It's just such a bad, bad, bad spot for you to be. Yeah. Okay, you know, I mean, this is just a very expensive way for us to make things look cool, but... I mean, why not? Is that something to gather? No, that's... Yeah, okay. Gather it. Gather it. Oh. Okay. Sweet. I just gotta mess around with this wall and this wall. And that wall. And this wall and this wall. Oh, we're one short. Of course you're one short. Suck. Suck at math. That's alright. I'll forgive you this time, sucky math guy. Because it still looks cool. I mean, you know, just don't go up that way. Let's see. Put the gasoline in. Turn it on. Moment of truth. Let's go look upstairs and see what we get. Hopefully blinding light. Well, these are on. So that's good. And it was good enough to make me poop, so that's good. What kind of temperature are we sitting on here? The same. I imagine that's just not going to change. It's like the perfect temperature. We'll have to try this again a little bit when the temperature's worse. Turn on. And turn on. Oh yeah, look at that blinding light. Awesome. Awesome, 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 awesome. Yeah, let's go turn that on. We don't really need to be wasting any more gas. Sweet. So we are all ready to bring in any of the eggs that need to be incubated, and we'll be able to keep it nice and safe. And why haven't you given me any eggs yet? Just poop. You see it worked, though. You see the ramp? It rolled down the ramp. That's good. Now I just need to actually be eggs and not poop. Well, one of them pooped again. Come on, guys. Eggs. That's going to do it for good old Jim Bob again, guys. I hope you liked today's episode. If you did, go ahead and drop me a like. If you have any questions or any suggestions for our barn here to expand and build, go ahead and leave me a comment. And if you like the series so far, I'd greatly appreciate it if you subscribe. We'll be back here again doing some more building very, very soon. Thanks again. Bye-bye.